Dear all, welcome to this tutorial dedicated to Trimble SketchUp, a fantastic and professional CAD tool that allows you to create quick and accurate CAD drawings in a very user-friendly interface. In just 13 minutes, we will cover all the basics on SketchUp Free, the free and online version of SketchUp for beginners and amateurs. For professional projects, you may upgrade to SketchUp Go, Pro, or Studio through a subscription plan, which also includes access to the desktop version. The core fundamentals of SketchUp remain the same across all these versions. You can access SketchUp Free by logging in with a Trimble account. Once done, the main home page will open up with various options. You can either start from your most recent projects or go to Open to browse for an existing project in SKP file format. Alternatively, you can choose Create New or Start Modeling to begin a new project. This opens on the main workspace. On the left side, you get the toolbar with several editing tools to draw and edit. On the right, several panels with additional options and settings to support your drawings. In the center, you'll see a preview of your project with a human figure as a reference, along with three main axes. The red axis indicates width, and the green axis represents depth, together forming the ground plane. The blue axis measures the height from such ground plane. To start drawing, simply enable any drawing tool from the toolbar first. If you enable the line tool, you can click on the preview to drop consecutive line segments. You can set the length of each segment with your cursor or by typing a specific value in the bottom right corner, applying with the Enter key. If the default measurement unit is not correct, open the Model Info panel on the right and select the right units for length and angles, as well as their precision. To finish drawing, simply press the Escape key or close the shape by connecting the last point to the starting point. In this case, the shape gets filled automatically. Enable the freehand tool to draw freehand by clicking and dragging on the preview. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and draw with more accuracy. To drop arcs, you have several arc tools, each drawing in a different manner. You can get tips on how to use any drawing tool from the instructor panel. You can also drop regular shapes with the rectangle, the circle, and the polygon tools by dropping 2 points on the preview. By default, these shapes lay on the ground plane unless you press the left or the right arrow keys to change the plane. You can undo any drawing in progress with the Escape key, whereas use Control or Command and Z to undo actions made. To drop 2D or 3D text, enable the 3D Text tool and type the desired content in the field on top. Set Font Family, Style, and Size as Height. You can also add Fill and set extrusion depth, and then go to OK to place the piece of text. To drop 2D text without any extrusion, simply uncheck its option. SketchUp includes several visual aids to enhance your drawing experience. For example, while drawing segments, these get colored according to the axis they are parallel to. Similarly, shapes get the same color of the axis they are perpendicular to. In addition, snappings can assist you in positioning your cursor. Colored circles represent endpoints, centers, and vertices of objects, while squares indicate points along paths and sides. Rhombuses appear on faces and fill areas. Besides these points, dotted guidelines appear to draw along perpendicular directions, intersections, or side extensions. Make sure to open the display panel to hide or show axes, objects, or even enable or disable visual effects like shadows and fog. From the Model Info section, you can manage the snapping options as you need most. Now let's see how to draw in 3D. The Push-Pull tool builds a 3D object by adding extrusion to a 2D object with fill. Just select the object and drag it as you need. This tool also works on 3D faces as long as they are not curved. You can also build 3D conductors with the Follow Me tool. Select a 2D section and then a 2D path perpendicular to it, following its direction as you need. For more complex 3D objects, you can use the line and the other tools by drawing each face one by one. You can also open the 3D Warehouse panel to browse for pre-made 3D models from the SketchUp Lab. Simply download the 3D object and click on the preview to import it. 3D models and text get listed in the Components panel. To manage the preview, you can enable the Pan tool to pan around the workspace and the Orbit tool to rotate your model in 3D freely. You can also open the Scenes panel to get a perspective view. SketchUp provides further tools to measure length and area precisely. Enable Tape Measure to measure distances or get point coordinates if you hold over these with respect to the project origin. Use the Dimensions tool to leave quick annotations on length. And the Text tool to calculate area from fill and faces. Now let's see how to edit 2D and 3D objects. Enable the Select tool and click on any object to select it, whether it is a segment or a model subcomponent, such as any side or face. You can deselect by clicking elsewhere. Once the object is selected, you can edit it as you need. Use the Move tool to move objects or model subcomponents. In this case, you also edit the entire model shape. To move an entire model without distorting it, you may select it entirely by clicking and dragging from right to left and including the model within the selection area. The same rectangular selection can be used to select multiple objects and edit them together. You can also right-click on the subcomponents and go to Make Group so that you select all of these with one click without continuous selections. You can always ungroup these with Explode. Text and pre-made 3D models usually come grouped, so that you can move and edit these as entities. As custom groups, you can explode them to edit their individual components or letters. Besides the Move tool, you can enable the Rotate tool and fix an anchor point and then the angle of rotation. By default, this rotates the object on the ground plane, shown by a blue goniometer. You can change the axis of reference with the arrow keys. With the Scale tool, you resize objects by clicking and dragging on the cubes along the X, Y, or Z axis. Whereas, with the Offset tool, you can add a 2D contour at a fixed distance from the original object perimeter. You can cut, copy, and paste selected objects with Control or Command and X, C, and V. You can cut any object to remove it quickly from your project. You can also apply materials to make your 2D fillings and 3D models even more realistic. Just open the Entity Info panel on the right and click under Material to browse through a diverse range of these, including metal, grass, brick, asphalt, and many more. You can also choose another as back material, which will be applied to the back side of the object, usually on a darker gray color by default. When objects are grouped, materials are applied on them entirely. If you're looking for additional materials, you can visit the 3D Warehouse website from your browser. When selecting any model, you can browse for any of its materials to download. Then, import the SKM material file by dragging and dropping it onto SketchUp and expand your material library. To save your project, click on the Save button in the top left corner. This is an SKP file that you can reopen anytime from your Trimble account. With the free plan, you will have up to 10 gigabytes of cloud storage. SketchUp Free also allows you to make great visual presentations of your models. Open the Styles panel to change the preview type by selecting the best style for your needs. Switch to the Scenes panel to create animations with your model. Set the desired point of view and save it with the plus button. By repeating this process with different viewpoints, you can create a smooth transition from one scene to another with as many scenes as you need. Thank you very much for watching this video, and don't forget to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to learn more about CAD design and free solutions for your business.